गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट स्टूडेंट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट अ न्यू पोएम अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी बाय जॉन किट्स अ थिंग ऑफ ब्यूटी बाय जॉन किट्स दैट इज मॉड्यूल नंबर वन दैट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट स्टूडेंट ब्यूटी इज ट्रुथ ट्रुथ ब्यूटी दैट इज ऑल यू नो इन लाइफ एंड आई ऑल नीड टू नो John Keats said these lines in his famous poem "Ode to the Grecian Arm." What is the meaning of these lines? Actually, John Keats, he was a worshipper of beauty, and he said that beauty is truth, truth beauty. It means in the complete world there is only one thing that is beautiful, that is truth, and truth is also a beauty. That is all we know, and in life we should know. There is a need to know about of the reality of this thing, that the actual beauty is lies in truth that is given here. So John Keats, worshipper of beauty, was born in London in the year 1795 and died in Rome in 1821 at the age of 25 due to illness. He is a romantic poet, and his poetry is characterized by sensual imagery in his most popular work, which is a series of odes. Odes, a lyrical poem which is meant for a particular subject. Today his poems are one of the most sought after creations in English literature. The above-given poetry is an excerpt from his poem Endymion. Endymion is a poetic romance that is published in 1818, considered to be an epic poem. Let's see student about of Endymion. Endymion, actually it is a narrative poem about the relationship between a goddess and her human lover. The poem is based on the Greek myth of Endymion, a handsome young shepherd and poet who lived on Mount Latmos. He had a vision of the moon goddess Selene, whom the poet renames Cynthia. The enchanted youth resolved to seek her out and so wandered away through the forest and down under the sea. This abstract thing of beauty talks of how a beautiful thing gives us pleasure and alleviates suffering and sorrow. This epic poem Endymion begins famously with the line, "A thing of beauty is a joy forever." Friend, let's see the poem, lines 1 to 5. A thing of beauty is a joy forever. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness, but will keep a bower quiet for us, and a sleep full of sweet dreams, and health and quiet breathing. First of all, this complete poem is composed in a rhyme. It has a rhyme scheme. That is all. You can see forever, never, keep, sleep, breathing, and the next line would be reading. It means there is a rhyme scheme of AA, BB, and CC. So this poem is a very beautiful poem that John Keats composed here. By the first line, he wants to tell us that a thing of beauty is a joy forever. It means whatever the beautiful things are, they are so beautiful, they are actually giving us a joy, and that joy is everlasting. It is not going to be die. That is a forever joy. Its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. It means its loveliness. You can see in the image that is given a beautiful scene. That's loveliness. Whenever the person, whenever a man or person used to go to see that particular thing, when he comes, he used to just explain about the beauty of that particular thing. It means that is the increasement of that particular thing's beauty. So its loveliness increases. It will never pass into nothingness. And its beauty, that will never pass into nothingness. It's not that when a person is just go and watch it, and then after its beauty will destroy. No, the beauty of a thing, that is a joy. That is a joy for everlasting. And that loveliness also increases day by day, and it will never pass into nothingness. But we'll keep a bower quiet. Bower quiet, what means a bower quiet? You can see here in the image that is given a tree, and a man is just taking rest under the tree. It means the tree providing a very comfort, a shade. That is for a passersby, that is for a person just like a bower quiet. And a sleep full of sweet dreams and health and a quiet breathing. It means this beautiful thing is very helpful for us. So after all, by this line, the poet John Keats wants to tell us that a thing of beauty is a joy forever. It means whatever the thing we watch, though that thing has the beauty, that is survived everlasting. Its loveliness increases day by day, it will never pass into nothingness. But this beauty will keep a bower quiet, it will take a place also in us, and sleep full of sweet dreams and health and a quiet breathing. It means it is very helpful for us. So spread, let's see the poetic device used here in these lines. They are bower quiet, metaphor. The poet used here metaphor. Next lines are here, lines number 6 to 11. Therefore on every morrow are we breathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth. Spite of despondence, of the inhuman dearth, of noble natures, of the gloomy days, of all the unhealthy and over darkened ways, met for our searching, yes, in spite of all. So in the earlier lines we have studied there that the poet explained about the beauty of that particular thing, that is everlasting, that is never pass into nothingness. And the next way, the poet is telling that, therefore on every moment, are we breathing? What we are doing in real? Are we just trying to breathe to us? Are we breathing a garland? You can see in the image there is given a flowery band. That by that band, are we just trying to unite, to connect to the human, to this earth? That's given here. So the first two lines here explaining about the meaning of that. On every morrow, morning means here morning. On every morning are we trying to just connect us to this earth. That is the poet saying us. In spite of despondence, it means the human life, we all know that the human is the creator of his all problems. Whatever the problems he is facing in his life, that is responsible for the human himself. So in spite of despondence of the inhuman dearth, it means dearth means the lack of something. The poet used here in human dearth, that is a personification that he used here, lack of humanity. It means we human has the lack of humanity, of noble natures, of the gloomy days. We are surviving in the gloomy days of all unhealthy and over-darkened ways. Over-darkened ways, it means all the dishonest ways people are using to achieve success. It means we people are just surrounded by all of these things, and that is our searching. That has become our searching. It means we are only trying to search all of these sorrows, all of these gloomy days. So the poet just wants us to that we should connect, we should unite through that flowery band to the earth, and also we should remove our despondency, our sadness, our gloomy days. Though we have a lack of humanity, the noble natures, but we should come out of from them, and we should also come out from our gloomy days, over darkened ways, and so on. So friend, let's see here the poetic devices the poet used here. First of all, a flowery band. The poet used here a flowery band to bind. Band to bind means alliteration, and a flowery band, there the poet used metaphor. Off, we can see the line number 3 and 4 that is given off. That shows the anaphora. Anaphora, it means the repetition of a word coming in the consecutive lines. That's given here. So let's see line number 11 to 13. Next lines are there. In spite of wow, some shape of beauty moves away the power from our dark spirits. So strength, the poet explained here, in spite of all our old darkened ways, unhealthy ways, some shape of beauty moves away the power. The power means here the sadness, the feelings that in which we are surviving, the gloomy days. So some shape of beauty that will remove all of these sadness, all of the over darkened ways. from our dark spirits. From where? From our dark spirits that will remove. Just looking a child who is looking very sad. But when he will just go in the lap of nature, in the lap of this beauty, he will just find a very comfort. And then after his all the gloomy days that will remove. So the poet used here some shape of beauty, moves away the pall, personification, and dark streets, that's his metaphor. So students, hope you understood this poem very well up to that. And now see the question for practice. Which things cause suffering to human beings? Lack of virtues and human acts, withering flowers, blooming flowers, flowing streams. So lack of virtues in any human acts, option number A. Second, how is the thing of beauty joy for evil? Because it is beautiful, because it is nature, because it is joyful, because it is beauty, never ends and leaves a lasting impact. Because its beauty never ends and leaves a lasting impact. Question number 3. What is the message of the poem? Beauty never fades. Beauty lifts spirit high. Beauty is a joy for evil. So right answer is all these. Next one. What does the thing of beauty do for us? Gives hope, gives happiness, removes pain and suffering. All these. So right answer is all these. What does the thing of beauty is a joy for evil mean? Joy is in memory. Joy is precious. Joy is not sold. It will keep giving happiness for a longer time. So that answer is D. It will keep giving happiness for a longer time. How does the thing of beauty provide shelter and comfort? By giving a sense of joy and happiness, by removing pain and suffering, like a bower. All these. So that answer is all these. So student, let's see, this is time for assignment. So describe the kind of joy a beautiful things provides. Next one, why does the thing of beauty not pass into nothingness? Next, why is there an inhuman dearth of noble natures? What are unhealthy and over darkened ways? And the last one, what does the land therefore are we breathing a flowery band to bind us to the earth suggest? So students, hope you understood this poem very well. See you soon in the next module. Thank you. Thanks for watching.